let's get to our very first email question. We did have some email questions come in, so let's get to one of them. And this question simply says, I was hurt in a car wreck that was not my fault. Who's supposed to pay my medical bills? That's an excellent question.
Well, that's a question we get every time something happens. And most people, unfortunately, when you tell them, well, let your insurance, whether it be your health carrier or your car insurance, if you had MedPay, their first reaction is, why should my company pay for the medical bills when it's the other guy's fault? But that's just the way it, that's just the way it is. And BJ, why don't you expound on that a little?
Yeah, unfortunately, we get that all the time. One of the cases we did sign up during the coronavirus was, you know, I went down to the medical center, sat outside in the little park area with the wife of a man who was very seriously hurt in an accident. And all she was concerned about was who was going to pay all these bills, because he was in intensive care for a while, and his bills were going to be hundreds of thousands of dollars. And the truth, the hard truth is that they're responsible for the medical bills, the patient. Hopefully, you know, he had Medicare, and some have insurance that pay it. But just because you're injured in a wreck and it's caused by somebody else doesn't mean they have to pay anything. The only time they have to pay anything is when a judge or a jury says they're liable, and then only to the extent of the coverage they have.
And the interesting thing about that also, Morgan, is the fact that most health insurance companies, and it also includes Medicare and Medicaid, they have a subrogation clause that we are having to encounter on almost every wreck case we're involved in. And that basically is saying that the insurance company that pays out for medical bills for injuries that were caused by someone else, if a recovery is made against the person that caused the wreck, then they're claiming that the injured party should pay back the insurance company for what they paid out. And so we encounter that day in and day out on almost every case we see. And it is very problematic. It was not like this 10 or 15 years ago. Medical bills were paid by whatever insurance company, health insurance company was available. There were no rights of subrogation, but they're in every policy today.
Yeah, which means the plaintiff, the client, gets less, unfortunately.
Right.
Oh, wow.
We're basically working for the client and that client's insurance company.